Hey everyone, welcome back for another deep dive. Today we're going to be looking at this YouTube video I found. It's called Make $20,000 a Month Posting AI-Generated Health Videos.
Oh, wow.
Pretty catchy, huh?
Yeah, definitely eye-catching.
So, obviously, that's quite a claim. But it got me thinking about all the health videos out there.
Yeah.
And how AI is really starting to change the game.
Yeah, it's really interesting to see how many people are turning to YouTube and other online platforms for health information. I mean, it's not really surprising, is it? When you think about how accessible it is.
Totally. And this video actually mentions a couple of channels that have blown up, like crazy growth. One is called Healthy Lawn Life.
Okay.
Apparently, they started just a year ago. And they already have over 400,000 subscribers. And they're making over $100,000 a year.
Wow, that's impressive.
Right. And then there's another one, Medical Centric. That one's supposedly pulling in almost $200,000 a year.
It's incredible how quickly these channels can grow, especially when they hit on a topic that really resonates with people.
And what's fascinating is that this video claims you don't need any prior experience to get started. They're saying AI can do most of the work for you.
Really?
Yeah. So the creator of the video, her name is Batty in Business, by the way. She talks about using ChatGPT to come up with video topics.
Oh, interesting.
And then she uses NVIDIA AI to actually create the videos from those topics.
So you're telling me I can just type in a topic and the AI will spit out a whole video for me?
Pretty much. It's pretty mind-blowing. Like, you can even tell what kind of voiceover you want.
No way!
Yeah. And the pacing of the video, the music, even specific details about the visuals.
That's wild.
I know, right? They even gave an example in the video. They used cold water plunge therapy as a topic.
Oh, yeah. That's a good one right now.
Right. So it seems like these AI tools are getting incredibly sophisticated.
It's both exciting and a little bit intimidating, isn't it?
Yeah, totally.
Like, on the one hand, it makes content creation so much more accessible.
For sure.
But on the other hand, I can't help but wonder about the quality of the content. Can AI really capture the nuance and depth of a complex health topic?
That's a great point. I mean, these tools are amazing, but they're still just tools, right?
Exactly.
You still need a human being to guide the process, to make sure the information is accurate and presented in a way that's engaging and understandable.
And to ensure that it's not spreading misinformation, especially when it comes to health. That's a huge concern.
Absolutely. And then there's the whole ethical side of things. This video talks about how you can make money from these health videos, not just from YouTube ads, but also through affiliate marketing, selling products, even creating your own courses.
So it's not just about sharing information. It's about building a business.
Exactly. And if the content is being generated by AI, who's responsible for making sure it's all above board?
Right. Like, who's vetting those affiliate products? Or ensuring the information in those courses is accurate and up to date.
It definitely raises some questions about transparency and accountability. And I think it's something we need to be really mindful of as AI becomes more integrated into content creation.
I agree. It's a complex issue with a lot of layers.
Yeah, for sure. This whole AI health video thing is way deeper than I initially thought.
Me too. And it seems like we're just scratching the surface here.
Right. Like, this video also mentions something called YouTube automation, which sounds like a whole other rabbit hole to explore.
YouTube automation.
Yeah. It's like a system for putting your YouTube channel on autopilot.
Oh, wow.
I'm not exactly sure how it works, but it sounds like AI plays a big role.
It definitely sounds intriguing and maybe a little bit scary.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, what happens to creativity and originality if everything is automated?
Right. That's a valid concern.
So maybe we should dig into this YouTube automation thing a little bit more.
I think that's a great idea. Let's see what this baddie in business has to say about it and whether her claims of easy money and automated success hold up under scrutiny.
Sounds good to me. Let's dive in.
So this whole YouTube automation thing, it really is a fascinating concept, isn't it?
Yeah, it definitely sounds appealing, but I gotta be honest, I'm a little skeptical. Like, can you really automate everything and still create high quality content?
That's the $1 million question. And it's not an easy one to answer. This baddie in business, she makes it sound so simple.
Right, like just set it up and watch the money roll in.
Exactly. But I suspect it's a bit more complicated than that.
Okay, so let's break it down. What exactly does this YouTube automation system involve?
Well, she talks about a few key elements, like content scheduling, you know, using tools to automatically upload videos at the best times.
Okay, that makes sense.
And keyword research, finding those terms that people are searching for.
Right.
And using them in your titles and descriptions.
Right, to get more views.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And then there's channel management. Things like responding to comments, creating playlists, promoting your videos.
So it's not just about the videos themselves, it's about managing the whole channel.
Exactly. It's about creating a whole ecosystem.
And she's saying AI can handle all of this.
Well, not all of it, but it can certainly streamline a lot of these tasks.
Like what kind of AI tools are we talking about?
There are tools that can analyze your audience data and suggest the best times to upload. Tools that can help you find relevant keywords. Even tools that can help you create those eye-catching thumbnails.
That sounds pretty helpful, especially if you're new to YouTube and don't have a lot of experience.
Definitely, it can be a huge time saver. But, and this is important, AI is still just a tool.
Wow.
It's not a replacement for human creativity and strategy.
So you can't just set it and forget it.
No, not really. You still need to be involved. You need to have a vision for your channel. You need to understand your audience, and you need to create content that resonates with them.
So it's more about working smarter, not harder.
Exactly. It's about using AI to free up your time so you can focus on the things that really matter.
That makes a lot of sense. But I'm curious, are there any downsides to this YouTube automation thing?
That's a great question. And it's one that Batty in Business doesn't really address.
Oh.
Yeah, like what happens if everyone starts using these same AI tools and following the same formulas?
I see what you mean.
Won't that lead to a lot of generic cookie cutter content?
Yeah, that's a good point.
It's like the difference between a home cooked meal and something mass produced in a factory.
Right. You lose that personal touch.
Exactly. And I think that personal touch is really important, especially when it comes to building a loyal audience.
So even if you're using AI, you still need to inject your own personality into your content.
Absolutely. That's what makes you unique. That's what makes people connect with you.
Okay. So it's all about finding that balance.
Yeah.
Between leveraging the power of AI and maintaining your own authenticity.
Exactly.
But let's get back to the money for a second.
Yeah.
Gaddy in Business claims you can make a lot of money very quickly using these AI tools. Is that realistic?
Well, I think it's important to remember that success on YouTube takes time and effort.
Right. There's no such thing as a get-rich-quick scheme.
Exactly. It's possible to make a lot of money, but it's not going to happen overnight.
So those claims of $20,000 a month, probably a bit of an exaggeration.
I would say so. There are a lot of factors at play. The niche you're in, the quality of your content, your marketing efforts.
And probably a bit of luck, too.
Definitely. So, yeah, I would take those claims with a grain of salt.
So AI can be a helpful tool, but it's not a magic solution.
Exactly. You still need to put in the work, and you need to have a solid plan.
Okay, so we've talked about the technical side of YouTube automation and the potential downsides. But there's one thing I'm still wondering about. What about the content itself? If we're relying on AI to generate ideas and create videos, how do we know the information is accurate, especially when it comes to health?
That's a really important question, and it's one we need to be very careful about. There's definitely a risk of AI being used to spread misinformation.
So how do we prevent that?
Well, I think transparency is key. Content creators need to be upfront about their use of AI.
So be honest about how the technology is being used.
Exactly. And they also need to take steps to ensure accuracy. Fact-checking, consulting with experts, citing sources.
That sounds like a multi-layered approach.
It is. And it's a conversation we need to keep having as AI becomes more prevalent in content creation.
Okay, so we've covered a lot of ground here, from the technical aspects of YouTube automation to the ethical considerations. But you mentioned earlier that Batty in Business, advocates for a multi-platform approach. What does she have to say about that?
Oh, yeah. She definitely talked about that. She was really big on not putting all your eggs in one basket. Like, YouTube is great, but you shouldn't just stop there.
Okay, so what else did she recommend?
Well, she said you got to use AI to, like, repurpose your content. You know, put it on other platforms, TikTok, Reels, even Pinterest.
So, like, take a YouTube video and turn it into a TikTok.
Exactly. AI can help you make those shorter, snappier videos, the kind of stuff that does well on those platforms.
That's pretty clever. So you're reaching a whole new audience.
Exactly. And the AI can even tailor the content for each platform, like adjust the pacing, change the visuals, make it more, you know, attention grabbing for TikTok.
Wow. So it's like having a whole production team built into the AI.
Kind of. It can even generate different voiceovers or add different music to match the vibe of each platform.
That's crazy.
I know, right? It's like AI is opening up all these new doors for creators.
And it's got to be good for business, too, right? Like, Batty in Business talked about diversifying income streams.
Oh, yeah, for sure. If you're on multiple platforms, you're not relying on just one. So if YouTube changes its algorithm or whatever, you're not out of luck.
Right. You've got other options.
Exactly. It's about building a more sustainable business.
Makes sense.
And AI can help you do that. It can analyze data from all these platforms, see what's working, what's not, even suggest content ideas.
Wow. It sounds like AI is becoming pretty essential for online creators.
I think it is.
Right.
It's important to remember it's still just a tool. It can't replace your own strategy or your understanding of your audience or your commitment to creating good content.
Yeah.